upcoming against Unicaja, so a big win to them for them tonight. Could see them go joint top along with Cluj-Napoca. And that is just going to be something very interesting, at least between these two teams. But one thing for sure is that the atmosphere is going to be electric. Now we're going to look at Promete, of course. Now, the big talk of this team is going to be Chris Doe, of course. I mean, this player, man, is shooting some of the best shots in the prime time for this team. D'Angelo Harrison, along with the hustle of Sean Evans. A lot of former St. John's University Vassal players, but there is Dario Georgia, one of the more experienced basketball coaches there. As you can see, top players such as Bratanovic in his team. Dario Georgia, one of the more experienced basketball coaches here in Europe. Also taking on the realms of the head coach of the Belgian national team. Well, Levi Randolph was a big addition along with Phil Booth this season. As we mentioned, 38 years old Dusan Djordjevic, the doctor of basketball, while Pierre-Antoine Gillet coming back to the team. Olivier Trois-Fontaines as well, coming into the head of his prime. Well, Dario Georgia, of course, has been with Fuluwa Stan for almost a decade now. And again, what a better success to get this team to start performing well here. And it would be a huge achievement for the club to get to the Final Four. Well, Promete, one big sign that they bought this season was Mirabalan. Now, Mirabalan had been playing for the likes of Dinamo Sassari, Banco di Sardegna for a few seasons. Of course, the big talk about them was Chris Doe, of course. I mean, the man stepping up and hitting the big shots in the crunch in the prime time. Getting some big, big victories, of course, for this team. Well, it's live, ladies and gentlemen, and it is, of course, the Basketball Champions League. Start to wonder what kind of style, of course, of Dario Georgia. Now, his players are very renowned for playing a very disciplined half-court set of basketball. You can't see them get out in transition. Again, in front of these very passionate fans. I mean, this has been one of the best teams in the history of Belgian basketball. Well, of course, statistically, if you look at the likes of Fuluwa Stan, again, this is a team that is 55% from within the rainbow and a 41% three-point shooting team. So, again, they are a team that can mix it up. Rebounds is going to be the problem they're going to face against in this matchup against Promete. Well, Promete now, she averaged about 40 rebounds a game. Points in the turnovers, of course, going in favor of the Ukrainian team. They are averaging 16 points from the turnovers. Second chance points again. The offensive rebounds could be a key stat in this one as well. But a lot is going to be about the points in the paint. Now, no doubt, one thing has been the difference for Promete this season is the inability to get the fine form of Mirabalan that he had at Banco di Sardegna. Dinamo Sassari. Well, there you can see coach Dario Georgia. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we will get set to introduce our officials for tonight's game, and we're very proud to say we have some of the finest officials here in world basketball. Our officials tonight are coming from Spain, Portugal, and Slovakia. Well, from Spain, we do have Antonio Conde. From Portugal, we have Paulo Marquez. And from Slovakia, we have Marek Kukeclic. Coach Ginsburg as well, one of the also bigger names in European basketball. Amanda, there are three officials, as we mentioned, Antonio Conde from Spain, Paulo Marquez from Portugal, and Marek Kukelic from Slovakia. Again, we're very proud to say we have some of the finest officials here in world basketball. They've done an excellent job in all of our competitions. And they're going to continue to do so here tonight, live in the Flanders country, in the round of 16 of the Basketball Champions League. Tempo will be key in this one, of course, as we mentioned. Now, one thing about these two teams, again, is going to be the heart and desire. We're going to look at the starting lineups. Now you can see Lukashev is going to start the point guard role. He'll be partnered with Chris Doe, the sharpshooter, along with DJ Stevens, and not to mention DJ Kennedy as well. Well, Mirabalan, the big man, will be starting inside tonight. Well, that is a very interesting lineup. As Coach Ginsburg, as we mentioned, Ronan Ginzburg, the man who took the Czech Republic team to the Olympics this season, last summer actually in Tokyo. Worked very closely with Czech international basketball. Right now he's doing the job here for Promete. Now we're going to take the agency, Levi Randolph, of course. And well equipped with a lot of experience playing in the Basketball Champions League with former teams such as Citigas Avellino only a few seasons ago. Well, there is a starting lineup. Doctor of Basketball, Dusan Djordjevic. He'll be partnered with Phil Booth in the backcourt. Levi Randolph will play the three spot. Pierre-Antoine Gillet, Anamida Brima will play as the center tonight here for Falu Asten, the starting lineup. There is the man, the myth, the legend, Dario Georgia. The man, and you can see the traveling friends for Promete making their way here to the Flanders country. I mean, this is a beautiful part here of Northern Europe. The beautiful Flanders country, as we said. Well, now just close, under 2 minutes away from tip-off. This will be a big game. Remember, Promete, as many of the experts said at the beginning of the season, they were to be the surprise team this year of the Basketball Champions League. Well, definitely meeting expectations because it was a tough start for them in their group. Remember, they had teams to go up against, such as MHP Reason Ludwigsburg. So it's been a bit of a tough bounce back for them, but they've done so well, of course, defeating Apoel Bank. You have Yerushalayim in the play-ins. Well, they took that to a three-game series, and now they find themselves here in the round of 16. And again, this is a team well-equipped, but so are Falu Ostenda. With Coach Ginzburg, Coach Dario Georgia, they'll be trying to get their players hyped up for this one. Ladies and gentlemen, we thank you for joining us here live in the Flanders country. This is the round of 16. It is the Basketball Champions League. While it is our host, Falu Ostenda, the boys in town, the man from Ukraine, it is Promete. Don't go anywhere as we are set for tip. Well, it's going to be a very tight encounter between these two teams in the early stages, but again, I think the perimeter shooting is going to be a key difference. If they can get a lot of good looks for Pierre-Antoine Gillet, along with Phil Booth and Levi Randolph, one team could take care of business. But Phil Doe, again, a great perimeter shooter, along with DJ Stephens as well. DJ Stephens now proving to be a huge addition this season for Promete. But if they can get the inside play for Mira Balan, it could be a long, long night here for Falu Ostenda. Underway now. Here you can see Falu Asten just trying to march their way through this game. Again, as we mentioned, tempo is going to be very key as he comes off one screen. Now tries a love pass and throws it out of bounds, but it's going to be possession back to Falu Ostenda. The deflection came off the defense. And again, a bit of a kind of a sloppy start there for Falu Ostenda. He got 3 seconds on the shot clock. Well, DJ Kennedy comes up with a steal. They got numbers here in transition. They use the numbers. They lay this one up as Doe gets fouled. Well, Chris Doe, the man who makes every shot at any point in the game. Going to go to the free throw line here now for 2 shots. great transition play there between DJ Kennedy, who got the steal, and Chris Doe. Now has a chance to put 2 points on the board for Promete, for that matter. The man originally from Louisville, Kentucky, played his university basketball at Bellarmine. Started his professional career in 2013. Now last season was playing in the north of Israel for Maccabi Haifa. Well, coming over to play for Coach Ginsburg here at Promete in Ukraine. So now he makes 2 free throws. Coming up one screen, there's the alley-oop. Goodness gracious, right off the start. And it is a bit of airways right now. And again, Levi Randolph sending Bream out of the alley-oop, and he throws it down. Well, that's a good way to get the crowd involved, as now Chris Doe comes up one screen, finding Miro Blandt again. Finds DJ Steffens, and now they go down low to the big fella. Blandt now backs down, beautiful post move, goes up, and again, it's just simply dream work there for Miro Blandt, the Croatian sensation. Well, again, we got a lot of great Croatian post-basketball players here in the Basketball Champions League. Miro Blandt being one of them, along with the likes of Ivan Buver as well. Well, there you can see Levi Randolph now giving the ball off, and they go back down to Amita Brima. Now he tries a post move, doesn't get it. Now Plummer taking the ball in the hands of DJ Kennedy. Kennedy now goes to go down low, and again the foul has been committed. Well, that is a smart play there by Miro Blandt. You can see just trying to smell it. Look at this. Randolph puts the dime up, and Brima throws it down. With a bit of authority here in the Flanders country. There's a shot in the key, doesn't get it. As now Phil Booth comes up with a rebound, and now Jordovic can push this one. Jordovic now throwing this one down low. Finding Levi Randolph. Well, Randolph trying to back down here in the low post. Tries a fadeaway shot. Doesn't get it. The rebound secured now by DJ Steffens. Well, here's a one-on-one matchup as now Balan spins out. Well, almost gets his pocket picked there. Great help side defense. A double team coming from Phil Booth. Watch Phil Booth really quickly just coming down. Again, just probably gets away with a foul there, but it's now going to be baseline ball here to Promete. Chris Doe now with a bit of time and space. They don't want to do that, but it hits the back iron, doesn't get it. Balan with the rebound. There's the penetration to pull up the one-legged off the backboard. Well, DJ Steffens is going to work. Curls the screen now. It's Phil Booth. He'll try his luck from the perimeter. Tucks that one away. And again, nobody switched on the screen. They left Phil Booth wide open. And the man who's once won an NCAA championship getting off to the mark on the perimeter. That's something for Lua standing in the need of this game. And misses this one in the post as now Booth can try to push this one. Jordovic now coming off one screen. There's a pump fake now. Tries the backdoor pass, doesn't get it. And the ball is secured, and now Promete can push this one. Doe now tries a bit of a Euro step, a little bit of floater, doesn't get it. It goes out of bounds, and that's going to be possession now back to Falu Ostend. Pierre-Antoine Gillet now checks into the game here for Falu Ostend. Jordovic now giving this one up to Levi Randolph. Well, Randolph had Prima wide open. This time they had the Bolton, puts up a tough jump hook, and he tucks it right over. Miro Blandt, a tough play there by Amita Brima. Again, this has been a battle of the post players. Now Blandt, he pump fakes, got to go up with it. And Miro Blandt, this is a battle of the big man right now. Again, you gotta love to see Both centers now just getting up and down the court and just cementing position. Ontario, Georgia. Man, usually full of expression there. Almost expressionless as now Chris Doe checks out of the game here for Promete. It's D'Angelo Harrison now coming into the game here. Hit 1 3-point, takes another one. Nothing but net there by Phil Booth. Again, same thing. This time he comes off the dribble, off the pick and roll, nails that three-pointer. Hitting his second treble of the evening. D'Angelo Harrison now. He tries to come off one screen here. Amir Bland guided heavily by Phil Booth. Again, they want to go to Amir Bland one more time, and he's looking like the old Amir Bland in the old days. Off the backboard. Well, feed the big man, and he will go to work. Well, that is the Amir Bland that we remember from his time playing for Banco di Sardegna, Dinamo Sassari. Kicks out to Jordovic now, finds Pierre-Antoine Gillet. He tries a three-pointer, and it is a cookout right now as Falua Stend lighting it up in the perimeter. Well, Gillet coming off the bench now and again, finding that confidence. That's one thing we saw in his career so far over the season. Remember, he also played for Lenovo Tenerife, making it to a Champions League final for them back in 2019. DJ Kennedy just losing control of the basketball, and it will be a baseline ball now here to Promete. Well, beautifully executed. Now watch. Gile sets the screen, pops out. One more pass as the assist came from Dusan Jordovic. That's good team basketball there from Falua Stenda. Ball comes off of Denis Lukashov, so it's going to be possession now back to Falua Stend. Well, Jordovic shaking and breaking now. Giving a bit of an ankle break, coming off one screen again. This time pulls up in the mid-range, in and out, doesn't get it. Now Lukashov here will push this one in transition for Promete. Goes baseline now, kicks out. DJ Steffens for three. He tries it, doesn't get it. As Falua Stend to secure the rebound. Randolph now looking to patiently build this one up, trying to isolate here against D'Angelo Harrison. Backs down now, goes in the post play reverse. Great defense by D'Angelo Harrison. And again, Levi Randolph turns it over. Possession. I mean, look at this defense here by D'Angelo Harrison. Hands up. Able to block the shot at the right spot. Now just trying to get into their offense. DJ Kennedy now coming off one screen. Find Amir Bland, almost fumbles the basketball. Now DJ Steph is all the way. Well, again, he was going to put everybody on a poster, but lost control of the basketball. Well, 4 seconds on the shot clock now. We got a technical foul is going to be called here on DJ Steffens. Well, look, I think he thinks he got fouled. To me, that looks like a good block there. Watch Brima. Brima just, I think he got blocked by the rim, actually. Well, I don't think a technical foul has been called, actually. So my apologies there to DJ Steffens. I think he just made contact with the backboard, but again, I'm going to resume play here. 7 on the shot clock now. Harrison goes all the way, gets rejected. Well, he got to get a shot off. The three is up. Doesn't get it. Another offensive rebound. Ilya Sidorov now coming into the point guard role here for Promete. Coming off one screen. Puts up a little floater. Again, can't get it. He had a wide open Amir Bland there off the roll from the screen. So now Phil Booth here will try to push this one here for Falua Stend. Kai Vandenbos now going up, puts up a little floater, doesn't get it. Both teams now just losing a bit of rhythm here in the latest stage of the first quarter. Sidorov now going pick and pop here. DJ Steffens now putting up a, gets rejected one more time. Well, Amita Brima said, not in my house. Still Booth goes all the way. Well, watch Prima. He says, this is the house of Falua Stend. Get out of here. You are not welcome. Well, that is just how you protect the basket at all costs there. Great defense. We got a timeout now as these two teams want to talk it over. Free throw shots here for Phil Booth. And Phil Booth now, as we mentioned, has been a huge addition this season for Falua Stend. Again, an excellent option for them to have in the backcourt to play alongside Levi Randolph. Well, again, when you play under a coach like Dario Giorgi, you have to have the hunger and desire because there's a coach who definitely demands a lot of his players. As Booth makes a second free throw now. It's a 5-point lead here to Falua Stend. DJ Kennedy now coming off one screen, looking to give this one to D'Angelo Harrison. They go down low again to Mirabalan. Here comes the post one-on-one play. Bland now fakes, makes a bit of contact. And Mirabalan is a man possessed here in the first quarter. Well, he now moves up to 8 points. He's having a phenomenal basketball game, 4-for-4 from the field. Again, it's just going to be a question of how long Promete can keep going to that option here on offense. The foul has been committed by Ilya Sidorov. The legacy Kai Vandeverst now coming off the screen. And Sidorov just making that little reach in there as now. Well, this is interesting now because now you can see Mirabalan is going to go to the bench to take a breather. Again, that's very interesting to see how they've limited his minutes. Along with Amita Brima, he's gone to the bench as well here for Falua Stend. Well, Petrov now coming in and playing that five role, so it's a small lineup. And they've got Alexander Lipovi, Ukrainian international. He's also in the game here. So Coach Ginsburg now trying to go to a lot of his lineups. But now Pierre-Antoine Gillet will go to the bench. Well, excuse me, will go to the free throw line right now for that matter. As we mentioned, Pierre-Antoine Gillet, a man with a lot of experience, one of the better-known Belgian international players. Only last team before he came back to Oostende, he was playing in Fuenlabrada and also played for Lenovo Tenerife, as we mentioned. Going to a basketball Champions League final in 2019 where they came second place. Lipovi now looking at DJ Kennedy. And with the absence of Mirabalan, it's going to be interesting to see how Promete now. Obi now makes a cut. Beautiful basketball. Oh, he's got to go up. And beautiful team basketball there by Promete as DJ Kennedy lays it up with the jump assist pass from Alexander Lipovi. Well, Lipovi made the cut to the middle and gave a quick pass to DJ Kennedy. A spin around goes all the way with a little left-hand hook. Can't get it. He was down to try a deep, deep three from Vandeverst. He can't get it. Another offensive rebound off the backboard. Again, third offensive rebound. As Promete struggle to take care of the boards. As now. Pierre-Antoine Gillet will make it. And there you can see the man who is renowned for perimeter shooting. Just saw his post-up ability. He now moves up to 6 points. It's a four-point lead now to Folau Ostend. Kennedy now catches it. Almost loses balance there. Great defense by Jantanen. Kennedy now forces up a tough shot. It tucks it away. Well, that is a very tough, tough post-up move there by DJ Kennedy from the mid-range. There's a layup there by Kai Van Der Vers. You can see just making that beautiful drive to the basket as he gets his first 2 points of the game. No help side defense from Promete. Looking for a handoff here, finding this one in the hands of D'Angelo Harrison. Petrov is one of those players that can't step out to the perimeter and can make those open shots. Yeah, no surprise to see him try and put the basketball on the floor. Well, there was a hesitation move, the fake out by Van Der Vers. Again, a tough, tough move there from a very hungry point guard. Kennedy now looking to kick this one out to Lapovi. 2 seconds on the shot clock. DJ crosses over. DJ down the middle, left-handed hook shot. Well, Fangaro, excuse me. And he lays that one up. And the DJ just mixing it up now down the middle. No help side defense. Well, there's a pump fake now. Takes the mid-range shot as Olivier Trois-Fontaine. Again, it's another turnover here for Folau Ostend. Now there's 2.2 seconds left here for Promete. Plenty of time to get the ball inbound and to get one last shot here at the end of the first quarter. We're getting inbound now. Sidorov puts up a floater. Oh, he almost got it. Well, that would have been the default button there on a video game, the way he took that floating shot from the perimeter. But ladies and gentlemen, at the end of the first quarter, it is Folau Ostend who have a 2-point lead here over Promete in the round of 16 of the Basketball Champions League. Let's take a look at the stats right now. 3 3-pointers for Folau Ostend. 3 for 4, 75% from the field. They're 4 for 11 from within the rainbow. Promete, great for 15. Let's take a look at the highlights now. Again, you gotta love that alley-oop play. There's the throwdown time there. That was the pack down play. And again, one thing you've noticed in this game has been the post play between Mirabalan and the bigs, of course, from Folau Ostend. Mirabalan, of course, as we mentioned, has taken his time to fit into this team here. Promete, never been the go-to option when he was playing at Banco di Sardegna, Dinamo Sassari. Phil Booth now with 2 early 3-point field goals, along with Pierre-Antoine Gillet. As we mentioned, the perimeter shooting, if it can be very good this evening from Folau Ostend, it could be their game to play tonight. Bremer there, you can see, just trying to catch himself. Cement position, the low block, and he's got to be very physical here tonight against Mirabalan. Well, DJ Steffens there, you can see, had one thing on his mind, but again, he got blocked by the rim. What a block there by Bremer. They're just too strong in transition, going to the free throw line. As you mentioned, if he can have a good game tonight, it could be a good evening here for Folau Ostend. So Promete now go pick and pop here with Petrov. D'Angelo Harrison now coming up one screen. As we said, Petrov can make these shots, doesn't get it. Rebound secured by Kai Van Der Vers. Now he'll push this one with Demetrius Kanji. Now tries to kick it out, intercepted there. Great recovery defense by Alexander Lapovi. DJ Steffens now kicking this one out, getting a ball reversal, but a foul has been called on Kai Van Der Vers.
First foul, number 6, Kai Van Der Vers.
Again, Petrov tried 1 3-ball, couldn't make his last one. Again, he can't make it. Again, another rebound by Kai Vandeverst and the point guard. Again, doing a good job of boxing out and securing the boards, but now gets a give and go here and almost turns over as Petrov. Well, keeps it alive now under the basket. Again, it's an easy little layup there. Well, Harris Bratanović just checking into the game, gets his first 2 points. Now Harrison now looking to go all the way with a finger roll. That is beautiful by D'Angelo Harrison. Well, that is a sweet little way to get your first 2 points of the game. Here comes the double team. There's a foul. Again, a very hard foul given to Mikhail Yantanen. Foul is going to be called on DJ Steffens. Well, he got Petrov and Steffens up in the air. And again, I'm surprised Steffens tried to back out of it. Well, this is an easy two here under the basket for Bratanović. I think they called the unsportsmanlike foul, actually. So it's going to be two for... I was very... surprised to see the call wasn't initially made, so Mikhail Yantanen is going to shoot two free throws and going to get the ball back. And this is good now. If hustle up there between Chris Doe, of course. It's now Fula Stender. They're going to check back in. Dusan Djordjevic, the doctor of basketball, as quoted by his head coach. So Chris Doe now back in the game here. It's interesting backcourt now. D'Angelo Harrison pulls up for a three-pointer, hits the front iron, doesn't get it. And the perimeter struggles still continue here. And another foul's been committed. And this one is going to be called on Alexander Lapovi. Kennedy now having to go to the bench. That's one thing, of course, Promete don't want to get into is any foul trouble here on the road. As the pick and pop, and they're trying a three. The three is up. The three is no good. And again, another offensive rebound here for Falua Stender. Could that be a key stat in this game for them? Well, Djordjevic now pulls up in the mid-range, tucks it away. And again, the veteran player gets his first 2 points of the game. Andrew Harrison now trying to shake and bake here and split the defense up. Steps out for a three-pointer, doesn't get it. Again, was that the best shot they'd taken? I mean, they need to get a bit more ball movement here for Promete. All the way to the basket. I think they're going to call a turnover here against Falua Stend. So 2 points for Olivia Toifonte will not count here. I think he just stepped out of bounds when he called the basketball, so correct call from the official there. Now Levi Randolph checks back into the game here for Falua Stend. Olivia Toifontaine is going to check out of the game now. Well, Levi Randolph has been their top scorer this season, averaging 17.1 points per game. Now defensively, he's going to have to try and get a stop here. There's also Mira Balan here. Backing down against Bratanović. Balan goes all the way, puts up a little jump hook, doesn't get it, gets his own rebound, goes up at it. Mira Balan now moves up to 10 points. And the big fella single-handedly cannot be stopped here. Well, cuts this one down now. He is now 5-6 from the field this evening. Randolph now coming off one screen, now going to pick and pop here. Well, no travel call, top of the key. He tucks that one away, nothing but net as Demetrius Konja. Chris Doe now find Mira Balan. Mira Balan laying that one up in the home crowd. They wanted a traveling violation. That's just good ball movement there. And a good pick and roll sequence between Mira Balan and Chris Doe there on the offense. Dusan Djordjevic now guarded by Chris Doe, looking to get things going on offense here for Falua Stand. And Levi Randolph calling for a screen from Batanovic. 2 seconds left. Randolph's going to go up, and I think they're going to call an illegal screen there against Batanovic, I believe. Let's have a look at the replay. Well, maybe they could call the offensive foul on Levi Randolph there, possibly. Well, there was the mid-range shot. Well, that's not a traveling violation at all. That's great footwork there. Concha. I mean, that is some yoga basketball right there. The forward lunge to keep the balance and just able to nail the jump shot. Harrison now looking for a handoff here with Balan. Oh, DJ Stephens now. Harrison tries a three-pointer, tucks it away, and he gets the first tray ball of the night here for Promete. Well, D'Angelo Harrison now moving up to 5 points. It's his fourth three-point field goal attempt, and finally his first one he's able to nail. It cuts it down to a one-point ball game. Randolph now trying from the mid-range, hits the front iron, doesn't get it. Harrison with a rebound, and now Promete on the run. The foul has been called. Again, just a little too aggressive there on the reach and just forcing DJ Kennedy to lose his balance. Is now Phil Booth comes into the game here for Levi Randolph with 5:44 to go here in the second. Well, Promete now with a chance here to take the lead. Chris Doe now kicks out DJ Stevens. Puts it up, doesn't get it, in and out. Doe rises, Harrison, three, hits the front iron, doesn't get it. Conja now goes behind the back and tries to isolate. The foul's been called on the ground against DJ Kennedy. Kennedy just got a little bit slow there to the spot. The foul is definitely on the ground, so it's going to be sideline ball. It's only the fourth team foul here now for Promete. Well, both of these two teams now one foul away from putting themselves in the penalty. So Phil Booth now curling the screen. Bland now has to recover on defense. Now great penetration down the middle. Has to go up, but it spins around. Another pimp fake goes up, and a foul's been called. And that is Mikael Jantanen going in with a few pump fakes and a few step throughs. Now he'll go to the free throw line to reward himself with two free throw shots. Well, DJ Stephens now goes to the bench, takes a breather as he picks up another foul. And then the Finnish international, of course, settling into life here in the Flounders, originally from Helsinki. Again, 21 years of age. He was college basketball at the University of Utah, so this is his first professional team with Falua Stenda. Again, what a big addition he's been this season for the team from Belgium. Chris Doe now comes down the middle, kicks out to DJ Kennedy. Kennedy now finds Miro Balan, pump fake. Miro Balan, oh my goodness gracious, Miro Balan. Well, was he looking at the basket? Well, I need to see a replay of that. Miro Balan, that is Croatian sensation basketball. Well, Batanovic tries a three-pointer and he nails it, nothing but net from downtown. Well, the perimeter shooting has been very good this evening here from Falua Stenda. DJ Kennedy now coming up with it. And Chris Doe, and again, they want to go to Miro Balan. A big fella wants to go to work. Takes out the Chris Doe, pump fakes, takes a one-legged shot mid-range. That is Chris Doe, spectacular. I mean, those are the kind of shots that you take when you're practicing your game when you're a teenager on the three-on-three courts. And right now, he's doing it at the professional level here in the Basketball Champions League. Phil Booth coming off one screen, and it is a shootout right now. It's Falua Stand, they're catching fire. Well, Phil Booth now hitting his third three-pointer of the night. But Promete want to get the ball to Mirabalan, and right now, Falua Sten, they got to get the ball to Phil Booth, and he missed a wide-open layup. And you can see D'Angelo Harrison, and again, another three. Doesn't get it, goes over the backboard. And that's an out-of-bounds violation, so it's going to be possession now back to Promete. Dribble handoff now here for Promete's Chris Doe now trying to shake and bake, pump fakes. Again, they go down low to Mirabalan with the time and space. They got to come up. There's a three-pointer, kicks it out, doesn't get it. Kennedy now trying to secure the offensive rebound as now Booth comes up with it. Now Fulua standing transition. Hodge now hangs in the air, doesn't get it. And now Promete came up with a loose ball with just over 3 minutes to go as DJ Kennedy comes up with a loose ball. Kennedy puts up a little floater. And the foul is on the ground. DJ Kennedy is infuriated. Well, he says that should be an at-one. He was in the process of shooting. Well, there's the foul right there. So I think that's the correct call from the official, to be honest. And I think the officials may review this one. Two free throws now here for DJ Kennedy. Well, he makes a second one now. Just over 3 minutes to go here in the second quarter. And again, it's a very close game here between Falua Stenda and Promete. Well, we got a timeout now as these two teams want to talk it over. And Coach Dario Georgia, again, very disappointed. He felt there was a foul down the other end. That should have been called for Demetrius Kanja, but again, the officials are not having it. Olivier Trois-Fontaine now will inbound the ball here as Falua Sten have a two-point lead. Now the full court pressure is coming for Promete. Now we're under 3 minutes to go here in the second quarter. Yanton now looking to go in the low block now, has to kick this one out. Phil Booth has a hot hand, he has to kick it out. Trois-Fontaine now will try a three-pointer. The three is up and it is cash money right now. Raining three-pointers here in the Flounders country. As Trois-Fontaine gets his first 3 points of the ball game, it's a 5-point lead now to Falua Stenda. Doe now coming off one screen for a handoff here as DJ Kennedy now goes down the middle. But Kennedy waited for Mirabalan to roll to the basket. And Kennedy now tries a three, puts it up, and DJ Kennedy responds with a huge tray point up. Well, the assist coming from Mirabalan now. You can see what's happening to Falua Stenda on the defense. So much focus on Mirabalan, they're forgetting that, you know, Promete do have a couple of perimeter shooters in the team. Abreu goes up for a soft shot. He gets fouled, but he's going to go to the free throw line now here for two shots. And just there with the left arm was a bit of contact. The foul committed. Well, Amir Abreu played his university basketball with the University of Connecticut. He started his professional career in Europe in Serbia after playing in the NBA G League with the Austin Spurs. Again, a man who's also played a brief bit of time in the NBA with the Indiana Pacers. Now, before coming to Fulu Austin, he was playing in Puerto Rico. Again, what a great addition he's been this season for the team from Belgium. Doe now taking a mid-range jump shot. A little bit short, doesn't get it as Phil Booth gets a rebound. Booth now looking to push this one. Got it by Alexander Lapovi. Well, finds Abreu under the basket. Great defense by DJ Kennedy. Now D'Angelo Harrison can push this one. They trail by 3 points. Harrison all the way looking for Mira Balan. Balan comes up, goes, and another rejection by Abreu under the basket. Finding D'Angelo Harrison, and he gets, yeah, one. And D'Angelo Harrison, again, the smallest guy on the court. There's the original play. Watch here, the block shot by Abreu, not in my house. And then the dish by Kennedy, finding Harrison. The smallest guy on the court is just going to work in the low block. Well, again, D'Angelo Harrison, this guy plays right to the end. He is just so strong. Just such a tough basketball player. The man, as we mentioned, fantastic basketball career he's had so far in Europe. Started his pro career in 2015 playing in Turkey. Like some of his other teammates, went to St. John's University. Last season, you probably saw him in the basketball champs league for Brindisi. Well, he ties the game up at 40 apiece with under a minute and a half to go here. Pierre-Antoine Gillet now just checking into the game here for Fulu Ostenda. Now Abreu getting a handoff of Phil Booth. The foul has been committed. It's a careless foul again. Now Phil Booth's going to go to the free throw line here for two shots. That's now three block shots in the game here for Amir Abreu, the Ghanaian international. Well, now Sean Evans checking into the game here. The also another player here for Promete who went to St. John's. Makes the second free throw now, puts him up by 2 points. So now Denis Lukashov is back in the game as Lapovi. He tries a three-pointer, three is up, and Denis Lukashov dishing it out to Lapovi. As he now gives a one-point lead, gets his first 3 points of the game. Well, the man who played for Ukraine in the FIBA Eurobasket qualifiers. Also played for Ukraine in the 2019 FIBA World Cup qualifiers. No doubt we're going to see him again as Trafontaine can't get the three-pointer. Now Promete now building in confidence as Evans throws it away. Well, Coach Ronan Ginsberg was wide open, but again, he's not going to take that shot. I'm just saying to his players, we got to play with a bit more composure. And right now, ladies and gentlemen, we got a timeout as these two teams want to talk it over.
Second for Pierre. Hey, curl out. We try to play all the time. What is his first action? What am I doing?
You. Hey, let's see me catching the curl.
Well, it's now a one-point lead here for Promete, but now for Lua Stender with a chance here. 17 seconds on the shot clock, under 30 seconds to go here in the second quarter. They try and regain the lead. Finds Bream under the basket, but they turn it over. And now with 23.8 seconds left, Promete have the lead.
Pick him, just rush him, we come and we clear. I want that you will be to start here, okay? We penetrate, maybe off test for you, okay? We start the tape, not before. What's up,
don't go so early. See, that was a huge statistical difference in this game right now. I mean, Promete, huge difference down the fact they've got a player such as Miro Valant, 26 points in the paint. Again, the perimeter shooting has been the big difference for Lua Stender. Question now for the home team is just how much longer can they keep shooting this well from the perimeter? And now 23.8 seconds left here in the second quarter. Now they're going to put the ball in the hands of D'Angelo Harrison. They got Sean Evans, Alexander Lapovi, DJ Kennedy, and DJ Steffens on the court. So it looks like it's going to be a double high screen now. D'Angelo Harrison is going to run the clock down. There's a screen now for Lapovi. Harrison now forces up a Hail Mary three. Doesn't get it. Well, ladies and gentlemen, at the end of the first half, it is Promete who have a one-point lead here in the round of 16 over the Basketball Champions League. Live here in the Flanders country. 43 to Promete, 42 to Falua Stender. Well, if you want to stick around and look at some of the stats and the highlights, if not, go get a drink, go get something to eat, but don't go anywhere too long, as we'll be back in just over 14 minutes for the second half. Well, statistically, this game has been played from two different angles. I mean, Falua Stan has just been shooting so magnificently from the perimeter, while Promete just trying to force the ball down low, making the use of their size and physicality with Miro Valant. You can see 15 for 26 from within the rim, only 3 3-point field goals. The rebounding is going in favor, along with the assists, to Falua Stender. Well, Promete do have four steals for that matter. It's been a key difference for them. Miro Valant, the top scorer in this game with 14 points, followed up by DJ Kennedy, while Phil Booth with 3 3-point field goals. Let's take a look at the highlights now from the first half. That was the backboard shot there by DJ Steffens. Now you can see a strong move there, making a contact. Well, Chris Donau just trying to mix it up, but again, they couldn't get that one, went out of bounds. Well, if you are an international basketball fan, you know one thing for sure is if this game gets on the line, with Promete have the last shot, you know who the ball's going to hands of. That will be Chris Donau. He hasn't even got going from the perimeter this evening.
Back again for Suarez. Mooney thought about the three. He's still thinking about it. He will never stop thinking about it. And the lead is 17, and Malaga are on the way to victory. Surely there's no doubt about that now. Fabulous by Mooney. Magnificat. Matt Mooney.
Reaches Vilnius. They don't want to go too soon. Okay, now it's go time. What's Bukavich is going to do? He's going to launch a three. Oh, he's fouled. Can you believe it? Who makes the big plays has made a huge play here. And Vadic, you just simply cannot foul the three-point shooter.
Brizuela, and now it's Fernandez. How about that from Bremer? He is having some half. A real gem from Ghana, he is. How well timed that was. As Fernandez tries to make his way in.
Johnson now back out to Ragland. Ragland splitting the defense. Oh, beautiful play. Throws it down. Well, Joey Ragland going pick and roll. And then it became the Zach attack. I mean, that is simply Zegadol.
Coleman goes to work. Back outside. And Clark, goodness me. He hit the runway and wow. As he took a step right about here, and there was only going to be one result. And don't forget, he is the king of smooth.
beste vrienden van ons vinden. We gaan jullie nodig in de tweede helft. Smeer die stem allemaal op. En gaan zingen.
Second half of this round of 16 basketball Champions League fixture between our hosts for Luostan and the visitors from Prometeia of Ukraine. Well, it's a 1-point lead right now here to the visitors. They lead 43-42 over our hosts here in the Flanders, country of Belgium. Looks like it's going to be an interesting change to their lineup. It looks like Alexander Lapovi is going to come into the lineup here for Prometeia at the start of the second half. And there you can see Pierre-Antoine Gillet. Get a man that probably, for Luostan, probably want to try and get as many good looks. Antoine Gillet, as we mentioned. Another player that gets some good looks and another block there, the fourth block of the night here for Amida Brima. Well, Djordjevic now finds Pierre-Antoine Gillet. Gettys hit 2 3-pointers, takes another one, doesn't get it. Well, Brima almost got the offensive rebound. I think a foul's going to be called there against Brima, as he just held on to right there. If you look at the replay, well, it's a slight bit of contact. Look at the block here, the fourth block of the night. This guy simply is protecting the kingdom of Luostan. Well, it's now a 2-point lead here to the home team. And a team that's been with the basketball Champions League every season so far. It's now the rookie season here for the visitors. Both of them now find themselves to go down low here to Mira Balan. Balan's top scorer in this game with 14 points. Backs his way down, just too big and strong. Goes to work, Mira Balan. Well, again, this is a replica of his former self when we saw him playing in Dinamo Sassari. He's now 8-for-10 from the field this evening. He remains top scorer in this game as now Phil Booth comes off one screen. Alley-oop, goodness gracious, well, almost connects with it, goes out of bounds. I think Amida Brima, he wanted a foul there, but that was great defense by Prometeia. Well, Mira Balan just gets his movement there enough. Put the pass under pressure. Now, maybe a little bit higher, and Amida Brima would have made contact with that one. He's definitely thrown it down. But nonetheless, it's another turnover now for Luostan and another waste opportunity. And now, back his way, pump fake, turning around, spinning, twisting, gets his own rebound, and now he is just taking this game over. Well, young players, if you are watching and you are a post player, you got to pay attention to the footwork of Mira Balan. How he cements himself in the low block, how he backs down, and just how he reads the defense. And Levi Randolph now shaking and baking, nowhere to go. Great defense by DJ Kennedy. 5 on the shot clock now here for Randolph. Finds Phil Booth. Booth has got to shoot it. 24-second violation. Well, another poor offense there by Luostan. Well, at that point, either Phil Booth or Levi Randolph, I mean, they're great players. The kind of players you put the ball in the hands of and expect to be able to get a shot off. The foul is going to be called. I think they're going to call that on Amida Brima for knocking over D'Angelo Harrison. Well, that's his third personal foul of the game. And I think already Bratanović is going to come in and make a change for him. It could be a bit of a loss now for Falua Snend. Baseline ball now here to Promete to get the ball in bounds to D'Angelo Harrison. Finds Belan now. Belan goes all the way off the backboard and he gets the and one. Fence. And he is going to go to the free throw line now here to make the 3-point play. Again, you think about the teams he's played for. He played for six Strasbourg back in the 2017-18 regular season of the Basketball Champions League. Again, what a fantastic career he's had. As we mentioned, two seasons playing for Dinamo Sassari. Now Pierre-Antoine Gillet looking for a handoff here. Levi Randolph. Randolph goes down the middle. Randolph goes up. Strong move going to the basket. Kisses that one off the backboard. And that's what they need more from Levi Randolph, just to get to the bucket. Now D'Angelo Harrison all the way. And again, D'Angelo Harrison responds down the other end. The defense of both these two teams a little bit slow to react and probably just anticipating. Both teams going to pull it from the perimeter now. Djordjevic down the middle. Djordjevic now puts up a little tough hook shot. Well, excuse me, a little jump shot. A little jump shot there in the paint. And that's what they need from the veteran players. He now moves up to 4 points. He's 2 for 3 from the field this evening. Chris Doe now finds Mirabaland under the basket. Mirabaland finally misses, but he gets fouled. And the Croatian international is going to go to the free throw line here for two shots. One thing about having a player like Mirabaland in your team, again, the movement off the ball is just very professional, a great understanding, a high basketball IQ. When we talk about his ability to post up and play the one-on-one play in the basket, near the basket. There's 6:54 to go here in the third quarter. Promete looking to pick up their second victory after shocking Unicaja at home, which was a 3-point dagger from Chris Doe. Big man now makes it 2 for 2. I mean, this third quarter has been all Mirabaland right now. He now moves up to 22 points, two rebounds away from a double-double. Again, we're talking about Mirabaland, who's only averaged 7 points per game this season, having to settle into a new environment, a new system. Yusha Djordjevic goes up, gets rejected. Well, again, what can Mirabaland not do on the court this evening? Djordjevic thinks he's got it. Milan says, get out of here. I don't think he had to jump far off the ground on that one. Randolph now down the middle, puts up a little teardrop, gets the drop on it, hits the backboard. Again, cuts it down to a 2-point ball game. And again, Levi Randolph finding a little bit more success there. Penetrate to the basket. I think the officials are just going to stop playing and review this one. If the officials now are just trying to discuss what was left on the clock when he took that one. And this will be very interesting to see what they're going to do in this one now. And you can see Chris Doe now coming off one screen. Taking a mid-range shot, nothing but net. Well, that's D'Angelo Harrison, excuse me. Well, D'Angelo Harrison now moving up to 12 points. He's 4 for 6 from the field this evening. Now Levi Randolph leading the scoring so far here in the third quarter. 4 for Lua Stend. Randolph now putting up another floater. Levi Randolph. Sweet little jump hook there in the lane. Little teardrop. He's got 6 points in all six of them now coming here in the third quarter. Four for Lua Sten. Kennedy now finding Mirabaland. Mirabaland, simple pick. Oh, he missed a wide open layup. The foul has been committed by D'Angelo Harrison. Well, that is just a beautifully executed pick and roll, and again, Mirabaland has got to make that one. Foul committed right after by D'Angelo Harrison. That is now the only first team foul here for Promete, while for Lua Sten do have 14 fouls. And Phil Booth now checking back into the game here for Lua Sten. Finding Dusan Djordjevic under the basket. Tough pass to Bratanović. Well, 3 seconds, they got to shoot it, but goes out of bounds. Another turnover. And again, sloppy offense here by Lua Sten. Tanovich now trying to prevent Mirabaland from catching the ball. And again, very tough defense. And then now backing down, going down the middle. Mirabaland going up, and again, simply unstoppable. Miracle Baland is going to work. 24 points, 11 for 15, 73% from the field this evening. Where has Miracle Baland been this season? Remember, he averages 7 points per game. Last year, it was 18 points per game for Dinamo Sassari. Randolph now looking to put up another teardrop. Doesn't get it. Rebound by DJ Kennedy. Kennedy now cross court. Finds Mirabaland. Transition. Oh, baby! Miracle Baland is running transition basketball. And Promete are taking this game over, led by that man, the Croatian sensation. Well, he does it in the post, but he runs transition. And again, could this be the turning point? I mean, look at the post up. This is beautiful. Dream work. Pump fake. Turn around. It has been the Miracle Baland show.
Guys, listen to me here. Pick and rolls when we use it, they're dropping us now here. We need to escape. We need to open passing line to transfer ball. Or read this pass here and then we attack. Okay? Listen. Go once with the one down. Listen carefully. You will slip, Harris. Say, we get a ball. Harris, you're slipping. Here, go over. Don't pass to the ball. Keep the ball going to pick and pop. And don't set the screen. Slip it. Hey, this guy, this is a wide corner. Continue one side. Come on down.
Hey.
Well, 6 point lead now, the biggest lead of the game here for Promete. Again, we're only just under halfway to go. Over halfway to go here in the third quarter. Well, for Lua Sten now, just trying to gather some momentum here. There's the pick and pop with Pierre-Antoine Gillet. Djordjevic, big three in the corner, takes it. Well, an offensive foul's been called. And the legal screen was set. This is key now. Here comes the pick and roll. D'Angelo Harrison for three. Nails it. Well, if they start raining the three-pointers from the backcourt, then this could be Promete's game. As D'Angelo Harrison now moves up to 15 points, a 9-point lead now. Well, Djordjevic tries another three-pointer, responds down the other end, and that is a crucial three-pointer for Lua Sten. He just keeps their confidence in this game. It's now a 6-point ball game. Well, Lapovi, why not? He tries a three-pointer, doesn't get it. And again, that was a very poor shot. Coach Ginsburg probably not happy with that one. And commits a foul there. Well, I don't see why that would ever be upgraded to an unsportsmanlike foul, because he does have his hands up. Well, so he does actually reach in. I thought he had his hands up there. Look at Doctor of Basketball. Did you call for an appointment? And again, because Alexander Lapovi did reach, the officials are going to review this one. And that could be a big game changer. Confidence was flying. Remember, Miracle Belan, 26 points right now. D'Angelo Harrison stepping up. Alexander Lapovi is a fantastic basketball player. But again, going for a quick three-pointer, then committing what could potentially now be an unsportsmanlike foul. Could be a huge game changer here for Falu Ostend. And the officials now will review. Kept the regular foul there, so that is a bit of a saver there for Promete. Again, I think if you look at the replay there, it did look like minimal contact, but again, you do see those given from time to time, especially in transition. Now, Belan has gone to the bench. Sean Evans is coming to the game here for Promete. So again, they're going to try and probably rest him up here for the last 3 minutes and 44 seconds, but this is crucial time now for Falu Ostend to gather some momentum. Jordanovich now looking to go pick and roll here. Pulls up from another mid-range, and the doctor of basketball nails it. Cutting it down to a four-point ball game. 9 points now for the Duck. Again, that is a crucial shot there. Just stepping up and showing the veteran he is. As we got a timeout now as Coach Ronan Ginsberg wants to talk it over.
Close to it, okay? On offense, next time we play the fist side, okay? Fist side, okay? You know what? No. Yeah, this side is good. This side is good, okay? We don't have, we can penetrate. We have DJ, maybe we can push the ball inside, all right? I defend. Let's go.
Come here.
Hey.
No more fouls.
Well, Sean Evans now looks like he's going to come in and play the five role here. It's going to be a small ball scenario here for Promete. Again, if you want to talk about taking care of the basketball and what kind of game this has been, I mean, Promete, the visitors, so far in this game, they only have one turnover. Falu Ostend do have 11. That's a crucial stat. Not many teams in professional basketball, especially at this level, can come here right near the end of third quarter with only one turnover. There you go. There's a second one. Well, maybe. Maybe I just jinxed them. DJ Steffens there. You can see trying to go handoff with D'Angelo Harrison. Just a little too casual, but great defense by Falu Ostend. Just trying to pick themselves up emotionally as well as mentally here. And Jordanovich now, he's got the confidence. He's been leading the way so far. There's the kick out. Spin out, goes up with a tough shot, nails it. Cutting it down to a two-point ball game. And Demetrius Kanji now, he goes up to 4 points. Promete now, remember, they were up by as many as 7 points, but without Miro Belan on the court, it's a different game for them at the moment. It's DJ Kennedy looking to back down here against Levi Randolph, kicks out. DJ Steffens, and now D'Angelo Harrison from no man's land. Well, again, that looked like he was going in. And now Falu Ostend here with a chance to tie the game up, possibly take the lead, but a foul has been called. That's only the 13th foul here. Promete, so not a bad foul there by D'Angelo Harrison. Smart play there by Demetrius Kanji there, just trying to make the most of a mismatch in the low block. And it's going to be a baseline ball as now Kushov now comes into the game. Doctor of basketball checking out, taking a breather as now Kai Van de Vers comes back in. So both benches now just trying to Stretch that bench here in the latter stages. Baseline. Randolph goes up, gets fouled. Smart move. Well, completely caught DJ Kennedy off guard there. Well, DJ Kennedy just fell asleep there on the help side defense. Just took his eye off of Levi Randolph. So now Levi Randolph with a chance here. Too tight a game up with these free throws. Levi Randolph, a man, as we mentioned, well, now the miracle has come back into the game. And for obvious reasons, well, Levi Randolph, as we mentioned, having played in the Basketball Champions League before for Citigas Avellino, also played for SIG Strasbourg and Dinamo Sassari. Well, before returning back to Europe, played in the NBL for the New Zealand Breakers, so a man with big experience in the international basketball world. Missed a second free throw. Harrison now comes up, and they got numbers in transition. Finds Lukashev now. And Promete here with a one-point lead, just like they did at the end of the first half. And one option to go down to Mirabalana. You can see Pierre-Antoine Gillet with the help side defense. DJ Steffens for three. Doesn't get it. And again, falls to Mirabalana with a one-handed jam. And again, he now finally moves up to it. Well, look at that by Lukashev. I think the assist is going to come from Pierre-Antoine Gillet. Again, I don't think he's going to be rewarded with it. But I think Mirabalan's going to definitely thank him at the end of the quarter for this one. Kai Vander first, a one-legged fadeaway, doesn't get it. Well, the foul under the basket. As Amita Brima is going to go to the free throw line now for two shots. Foul is going to be called, I think, on DJ Steffens. So, well, Brima does so well there to sky up and keep the basketball high and just draw the foul. Well, born in Accra, Ghana. As we mentioned, went to Florida in the United States to play his high school basketball before playing for the infamous University of Connecticut Huskies. Well, he makes the first free throw. As we mentioned as well, having a bit of NBA experience with the Indiana Pacers before going and playing in Puerto Rico. Well, this is now his second time now playing professional basketball here in Europe. His first time playing was in Serbia, in the capital of Belgrade, as he makes a second free throw, cutting it down to a one-point ball game. And under 2 minutes to go here, Sean Evans looking for a handoff with D'Angelo Harrison. Lukashev now finding 1-2 pass, and another foul's been committed, so Mirabalan's going to go back to the free throw. I mean, this third quarter has gone on forever. Well, Mirabalan had 14 points at the end of the first half. He's now scored another 14 points and has one rebound away from that double-double. He has a chance to go up to 30 points here. He can make these both free throws. He makes the first one. As I mentioned, ladies and gentlemen, I mean, this is a spectacular performance because the last two seasons, Mirabalan has been the go-to option for Dinamo Sassari, averaging just under 20 points per game. This season has been a big struggle for him, only averaging 7 points per game. And again, this is the Mirabalan, the miracle that we've known for the past few seasons, the miracle that played for Sassari. And right now, putting Promete up by 3 points with just over a minute and a half to go here in the third quarter. Kai Vandevri, alley-oop. Oh, he missed it. Gets his own rebound, but he gets fouled. Well, again, the slow reaction from the defense there. They could have came up with a loose ball, but Amita Brima is going to go to the free throw line for another two free throw shots. Well, that's a great little dime there, but again, Amita Brima just slightly under the basket, unable to connect with that one. Well, Coach Dario Giorgi now, again, looks very calm as opposed to his usual. I mean, he's a very passionate man. He loves the game of basketball, of course, spending a decade here in Belgium. Now taking over as the head coach of the national team after the good work of Eddie Castells. Well, some great names, of course, working with the Belgian national team, such as Paul Verbeek and Eddie Castells, some of the older names here in the professional game of Belgian basketball. But right now, Dario Giorgi, DJ Steffens now kicks out to Lukashev. Lukashev goes up, gets rejected. Well, Amita Brima, fifth block of the night. Blank comes up with a loose ball. Again, no foul called, and it's a turnover. Promete lose possession, but again, it's the man from Ghana, Amita Brima, protecting the basket. One more time. This is the house of Folau Osten. Amita Brima says, get out of here. Well, D'Angelo Harrison, again, tried to go up for a last resort there. Well, Brima says, no, sir. Get out of here. Access denied. Well, now Folau Osten here under a minute to go with a chance to take the lead. And again, it's a football possession, so it's going to be sideline to Folau Osten. D'Angelo Harrison. Well, Dario Georgia must be doing some yoga right now because he is looking way too calm. Fantastic basketball coach, as we mentioned, but again, a lot of emotion from him usually. Pierre-Antoine Gillet, big three. Nails it! Two-point lead now to Folau Osten. And the crowd just start to come to life again. And he now goes up to 12 points, 3 for 4 from the perimeter this evening. Bland looking for a handoff here to DJ Steffens. Well, DJ Steffens, I think, tried to throw the give and go there with Mira Bland, but well, that was the penetration by Vandenberg. Finding a 3-pointer there from Pierre-Antoine Gillet. Doesn't even bring the ball down when he catches it. That's a hot skill, ladies and gentlemen. Young shooters, you noticed. Where Pierre-Antoine Gillet caught the basketball, he went straight up for the shot from the three-point line, and that is how you get the shot off here at the fast-paced level of the Basketball Champions League. Two-point lead now to Folau Osten. Now Vandenberg coming off one screen, goes all the way. Well, Vandenberg, I don't know if he tried to pass that or shoot that, but in the end, still scored it. And that's a smart play there by D'Angelo Harrison, just drawing the foul quickly in transition. I mean, Promete, as soon as they gave up the basket, they got the ball inbound straight away. And D'Angelo Harris, I mean, I think he tried to pass that one. His eyes were on Yantanen. Well, somebody needs to ask Kai Vandenberg at the end of the game, were you trying to shoot that or pass that? Because his eyes weren't on the basket. But as I was saying, you can see how quickly Promete just got the ball inbound. D'Angelo Harrison just drawing the foul. That's a very smart play to go right back to the free throw line. Well, Amita Brima and Demetrius Kanja will go to the bench and take a breather, as well as Mira Bland. He goes to the bench for Promete. Well, he makes the first free throw. Having spent a few good seasons playing in Israel, the first time he played in the Israeli Winter League was with Apoel Gilboa Galil. Cuts down to a two-point ball game, so now Folau Osten can dribble this one down now for the last shot of the third quarter. Gillet now goes handoff. Yansen all the way. Yansen lays it up. Beautiful. Now, Promete have a few seconds. I don't think they're going to try to get a shot off, but wow, goodness gracious. Why did he not try to shoot that one? Oh my goodness gracious. Christo can just make it from anywhere on the court. Well, that was the backdoor play by Yantanen, but I want to see a replay of Christo just doing Christo things, but beautiful play there. Well, at the end of the third quarter, Folau Osten with a big response as they win this quarter by 5 points. They take the lead now 72-68. Bland now with the back down play. As you can see, he has simply been unstoppable in this game. Arguably the MVP. Well, they just don't have an answer for him on the defense through Folau Osten against Mira Bland. You can see anytime he gets the ball. I mean, look at the spin around. He knows athletically he's not going to be able to compete with Amita Brima. But it's the back down post play, the intelligence, being able to read the defense. And Levi Randolph now coming to life here in the third quarter as well. I mean, he's had a very solid game so far with 7 points, all coming in the third quarter. Well, Brima has 9 points, followed up by Pierre-Antoine Gillet with 12. And Phil Booth has 13. Well, for Luau Stan, they shot 60% from the perimeter this evening, 9 for 15 from downtown. Well, Promete only 4 for 20, but the majority of those three-point shots coming in the second quarter. Well, there you can see Miracle now just backing down and going to work. And again, is that enough to get him over the final hurdle there? And you can see the big man running in transition. Well, he has 30 points, and again, one more rebound away from that double-double. Well, free throw shooting much better now by Falua Stan, just getting to the free throw line. Well, Promete now will have the first possession here. One quarter to go. This is the round of 16, and this is the Basketball Champions League. Well, Lopovi now throws it down low to Mirabaland. Here comes a double team. Lopovi had the three-point, didn't take it. Good ball movement. Chris Doe now takes a three in the corner. Well, no foul called. He was taken out. Chris Doe now still negotiating with the officials and felt like there was a lot of contact, but doesn't look like he's going to get it. Yantin now trying to back down against Lopovi. Amita Brima now gets a handoff. Phil Booth now goes to the lane. Booth goes all the way. Brima gets fouled, and he'll go back to the free throw line. Well, Falua Stan now looking like they're controlling the tempo of this game. And that was a great penetration there by Levi Randolph. Well, sorry, Phil Booth there. I thought he dished it off, but he actually lost control of it. That's a huge play there, but Promete just able to come up with a rebound. They fell asleep there on the rebound and find themselves down by 5 points now. And Chris Doe has the ball in his hands. It looks like he wants to go throw the ball down low here to Mirabaland. Vandenberg there waiting for the double team. Lopovi, one more pass. Good ball movement. DJ Kennedy, he tries a three-pointer. DJ Kennedy, nothing but net from the corner. It looks like Promete now have a response here to Luau Stan's defensive strategy to try and double-team Mirabaland in the low block. Randolph now shake and bake. Randolph all the way. Gets rejected! Well, the miracle just showing the defense. The foul has been committed. Oh, Mr. Miracle Baland doing it on both ends of the court tonight. There was the foul there committed by Vandenberg. And again, look at this. Shake and bake, but Miracle Baland, second block of the night. Well, the first block coming against Dusan Djordjevic. And that was a huge, huge defensive play there. And now he has a chance here to back down. Possibly tie this game up against Amita Brima. Kicks out to Chris Doe. Chris Doe now crosses over. Can take the lead. Doesn't get it. Not secure the rebound. A foul's been committed by Alexander Lopovi. Well, you can see Kyle Vandenberg all the way, doesn't get it. As Lopovi comes up with a loose ball, and now he can push this one. I think he's going to slow this one down and transition now for Promete. But this time they go down to DJ Kennedy in the low block. Kennedy now trying to go down the middle. Kennedy nowhere to go, kicks out. Huge three by D'Angelo Harrison. Doesn't get it. Well, Chris Doe with a little floater, he can't get it. Again, a bit of a poor shot selection. Now it's a 4-on-2 scenario here in transition. Kicks out, Yantinen, big three, doesn't get it. Well, Falua Stan had a 4-on-2 in transition. They went for the three-pointer. Now they've given Promete a chance to tie the game up here, possibly take the lead. Kennedy now finds Mirabaland, looking for another handoff. Tries to fake it. 30 points in the game, he's got to go up with it. And the big fella goes to work. Mirabaland is simply unstoppable. Fakes the pass, spins around, uses his right arm. That is just BEA. Beautiful post work there by the Miracle Man. Randolph now getting a handoff. It's Phil Booth going all the way. Phil Booth now trying to kick this one out, and you can see a deflection there by DJ Kennedy. 4 seconds on the shot clock here for Falu Ostend. We got a timeout now as Coach Dario Georgia is going to try and draw something up here for Falu Ostend here with 4 seconds on the shot clock. This is fourth quarter now, the round of 16 of the Basketball Champions League.
Continue to screen for Pierre. Okay? Hey, listen, listen, listen. At the same moment, hey, as you don't get the ball here, you're going that side. Hey, search him. Hey, Pierre and Amida off the screen for Pierre. You're going on the rim. Hey, Phil, here. Reading pass to Phil. Attack. Get a shot, okay? Hey. Hey, we have fouls to
now inbound play here. They got to get the ball inbound. They find Pierre-Antoine Gillet through in the corner. In and out. Doesn't get. Oh, the foul's been called. Well, he has been fouled by Alexander Lapovi. So now it's going to be three free shots here. And that's his fifth foul. And he is fouled out of the ball game. Again, it was a tough angle to get a good shot off in Lapovi. Let's have a look at the replay here. Definitely a foul because he goes into him. So now three free throws here now for Pierre-Antoine Gillet. I think what the officials now are going to review is if it was a three-pointer or did he have his foot on the line. I think the three free throws now, as he definitely did have his foot behind the line. And these are big free throws now here for Pierre-Antoine Gillet. Well, as we mentioned, a man with very invaluable experience for this team. Missed the first free throw. And again, you can see the response there from Dario Georgi. You just got to step up and make these shots. You never want to look back in a game and think the outcome could have been different had you made all your free throws. And he missed the second one, too. And again, the response from Dario Georgia. And Pierre-Antoine Gillet now just needs to hold his nerve now and try and make the final shot and give them a 1-point lead. 0 for 3 from the free throw line, and that is something you would not expect from Pierre-Antoine Gillet. Could that come back to haunt for Lou Ostend? Well, DJ Kennedy now coming off one screen here with Bland. Taking a handoff now, putting the ball in the hands of D'Angelo Harrison. Harrison pulls up, big three. Oh, baby! D'Angelo Harrison! Crunch time! Hitting a huge three-pointer. Well, coming off the screen there by Miro Bland, knocking that one down. And that is a big three-pointer. And there's a penetration by Phil Booth, and Phil Booth just able to tuck that one down. Well, cutting it down to a one-point ball game. Well, Phil Booth now, the former Villanova player, goes up to 15 points. DJ Kennedy now linking the penetration that somehow, someway, he makes the circus shot off the backboard. Again, these two teams now just trading field goals at the moment. Van der Verst kicking out. Conja, huge shot, in and out, doesn't get it. Harrison with the rebound. Has Kennedy ahead of him. Kennedy now, bit of contact, goes up, doesn't get it. Gets his own rebound, but another foul's been called. I think they're going to call this one against DJ Kennedy, actually. Well, Kennedy again, out of control. Great defense by Phil Booth. Right there with the left arm, just pulls back Demetrius Conja. That's what the foul was called for. Now Levi Randolph now comes back in the game. Just under 5.5 to go. This has been a fantastic game of basketball. It's a 3-point lead now here to Promete. Jordovich now gives the ball to Demetrius Conja. Tries to back down against Chris Doe. The foul is on the ground, and that's going to be... Well, that's a tough one there because it's definitely a foul. No arguments whatsoever. Hands all over him. The foul is on the ground, but it's a penalty foul. So because Promete have now put Falu Ostend in the penalty, it's going to be free throws now, and this could be crucial here for Falu Ostend. Well, he makes the first one. Dario George again. Unable to watch his team from the free throw line. As right now, he feels his team possibly could be up by 1 point, possibly two if he can make this one. After the three missed free throws by Pierre-Antoine Gillet. It's now a 1 point ball game here. Well, the referee got nutmegged, but it goes out of bounds. It's going to be a sideline ball here to Promete as DJ Steffens. Almost lost control of the basketball, but it will be possession back to Promete. Well, it's a big possession out here for D'Angelo Harrison. Kicks out to Kennedy. Well, that was right over Amita Brima. And that was a sweet shot. He now moves up to 19 points. He's 6-for-9 from the field this evening. Well, Falu Ostend now with the ball in the hands of Levi Randolph. And another foul's been called. And I think they're going to call this one a Chris Doe. So Falu Ostend are going to go back to the free throw line. Well, that's an interesting one because it was definitely... Oh, it's a right call there because you can see with the right arm, he just hooks that around Amita Brima. The only problem now for Falu Ostend is they have been 18-for-25 from the charity stripe this evening, 72%. Well, Amita Brima, 6-for-8 this evening for the free throw line, makes the first one. And again, if there was ever a time to step up and hit any shot, now is the time here in the fourth quarter, especially in the round of 16 here in the Basketball Champions League. Well, Brima missed the second free throw. Goes out of bounds. It's going to go back to Falu Ostend. D'Angelo Harrison felt that he was pushed to the ground. Well, there's not much contact there. Well, that's a huge rebound as well, given up by Promete, as they have 33 rebounds tonight. Falu Ostend with 32 rebounds. Well, here's a big three-point, but an offensive foul's been called. And again, Amit Abrima, a very careless foul to give away. And that is going to be his fourth personal foul tonight, I believe. Well, that's a tough one to me because it looked like he was set, but from that angle, and that is a very costly opportunity given away because that would have given Falu Ostan a one-point lead with 4:34 to go in the fourth quarter. Elias Sidorov now comes into the game here to play the backcourt role. Has not featured here in the second half. Bland now. Double team getting ready to come from Jordovic to go back to Mira Bland. Sidorov now tries a huge three-pointer. It doesn't get it. As now Pierre-Antoine Gillet grabs the 33rd rebound of the game now. And now finds Brima. Gets rejected. Well, what a block by DJ Steffens. Could that be a game-changing block? Well, Brima thinks he's got a throwdown, but DJ Steffens says, not in your house. That could be a game-defining block there by DJ Steffens. Denies him. Could that be the difference? 4:05 to go, plenty of time, but every possession now counts in this one. Randolph tries to go all the way, doesn't get it. Goes out of bounds, but that's going to go back to Promete. Well, you can just see and feel the adrenaline, the anxiety from both sets of players. We're under 4 minutes now. As D'Angelo Harrison is on the ball here. Chris Doe's gone to the bench. Mira Bland, the double team's a bit too slow, so this is his time now to go up and it. Gets the pump fake, and he gets it to drop. Well, the miracle man coming big. Moves up to 34 points now. Well, 15 for 19 from the field this evening. 4-point lead now here to Promete. Doctor of Basketball takes the mid-range and a foul's been called. And that has been the benefit from Falu Ostan getting into the penalty very early. So I think Amit Abrima's gonna go to the free throw. Again, look, when the double team doesn't come, that's the outcome. As we mentioned, Amit Abrima misses last free throw, makes this one. Now he goes up to 8 for 11 from the free throw line this evening. Well, it's 20 for 28, 4 for Louis Sten, in total 71%. Now if you make all 8 of those free throws, you're practically up by 5 points. He makes a second one, cuts it back down to a 2-point ball game with 3:20 to go here in the fourth quarter. Big possession now to go back down to Mira Bland. 34 points in this game. Bland now, no double team coming. Looks like he's going to go to work. Bland down the middle. Mira Bland, the miracle. One more time. And again, a turnover. Sidorov comes up with it. And I think they're going to call a foul here. Well, that's a 13 foul, so it's going to be a baseline ball. And it's a costly turnover for Lou Ostend. It's going to be a sideline ball, actually, as a foul is committed near the sideline, just over the free throw line. Now we're under 3 minutes to go as Demetrius Conjure goes to the bench. D'Angelo Harrison, another foul has been committed. This one's going to be called on Phil Booth. So now Falu Ostan with no more fouls to give anymore, and they'll be sending Promete to the free throw line. Well, it's definitely the right call because of the luck of arms there between Phil Booth and D'Angelo Harrison. Comes a pick and roll now with Harrison and Mira Bland. Kicks out Sidorov, huge three. Oh, baby! Big time shot! 7-point lead now. The assist coming from D'Angelo Harrison. Well, made the penetration baseline. Finds Ilya Sidorov, huge three-pointer. Well, that is just a big time game-changing shot there. Well, that is D'Angelo Harrison's third assist of the night. I think it was a two-pointer. Actually, he had his foot on the line. So that could be a bit of a big difference there.
What we need to take care now. Hey, he gets the ball down low. Force him base. Be ready for a base drop. So we will stay down low. We go base drop. Okay, we cannot do anymore. Nothing. When he start dribble, we go base. Okay? You send him base. Lock him and we go base drop. Okay? In offense. In offense. Amida. Pass to Amida. Here, get down low.
Well, this is a big possession out here for Falua Stand. I think they have counted the three-pointer. Originally, it went down as a two-point shot, but it's now counted as a three-point shot here. Pierre-Antoine Gillet, huge three-pointer, doesn't get it. Beland with a rebound. Well, it was a good executed offense, but they weren't able to get anything out of it. Now Harrison puts up a little teardrop, doesn't get it. Comes up with his own rebound. Well, no, actually scrambles a loose ball. And now it's a 9-point ball game to Promete. So over 2 minutes to go here. 22 points to D'Angelo Harrison. 36 for Miro Beland. 19 for DJ Kennedy. Levi Randolph takes the mid-range. He tucks that one away. Cuts it down to a 7-point ball game. And that's a tough shot now. Hand in the face. I mean, he sent that one up to the Alps. And it came down with a bit of snow on that high arc. Well, Miro Beland now, 36 points. Double teams getting ready now. Randolph now finds Sidorov. Six on the shot clock now. Sidorov now puts up a floater, doesn't get it. Rebound by Jordovich. Well, this is a huge possession now here as Phil Booth has the ball in his hands. Booth now pulls up for a three-pointer, nails it! Phil Booth, big time three-pointer! Well, Phil Booth now moving up to 8 points. He hits his fourth treble of the night. He is now 4-for-3 from the perimeter this evening. And that is a massive three-pointer by Phil Booth. Well, 80% from the three-point strike for Phil Booth, but as a team collectively, for Lua stand at 10-for-19.
I want to give you anger. You will be on the average.
Well, I don't know if you just saw that stat line, of course, but they said that Stephen Curry and the Splash Brothers of Klay Thompson revolutionized the three-point line back in 2015. But Miro Beland and Promete are taking us back in a time machine. 50 points in the paint tonight for Promete. Well, that is just a phenomenal stat line. Well, 1:26 to go here in the game. Promete now leading this one by 4 points. No more fouls to give for either team. Any foul will send them both to the free throw line. For Lua Sten now, they need a stop here. So D'Angelo Harrison now pick and roll here with Miro Beland. Finds Ilya Sidorov. Kennedy now has got to isolate. DJ, bit of contact. Kennedy doesn't get it. Rebound by Levi Randolph. And now Dr. Basketball, he's fouled. And D'Angelo Harrison. Oh, this is why you watch the Basketball Champions League. Well, D'Angelo Harrison now picking up his third personal foul of the game. And these are now big, big free throws here for Dusan Djordjevic. Well, the doctor of basketball, coined by his head coach, Dario Georgia, makes the first one. As we mentioned, free throws have been a bit of an up-and-down game this evening for Falua Stent. 22 for 30 tonight as a team. Can cut it down to a two-point ball game. Be a huge free throw here for Dusan Djordjevic. Makes it. Well, two-point ball game now. Falua Stent went down by as many as 9 points only just over a minute ago. Now they find themselves quite back in it. Well, Harrison now throws it down to Mirabalan. Balan gets fouled. And now he'll go to the free throw line here for two shots. Well, that was clever there. You can see just change of pace there. As Amita Brima fouls out of the game, so Jantanen has to check back in for Falua Stend. As Ilya Sidorov will go to the bench, take a breather. And I believe Chris Doe's come back into the game here. Makes the first one now. He's 5-for-6 on the free throw line. The Prometeas, the team, have only missed one free throw this evening. And that one free throw miss came from Mirabalan in the third quarter. As a team, they've only had 5 turnovers tonight, so they've done a great job of taking care of the basketball, but they've been pushed right to the end. Well, there you can see, makes another free throw, and it's back to a 4-point ball game. As now Sean Evans comes in for Mirabalan. Well, that's a huge decision there by Ronan Ginzburg. So now Falua Stent must score on this possession, and he must get a stop down the other end. Randolph now takes a three-pointer. Huge shot. Doesn't get it. Well, again, was that the right shot to go for? As now D'Angelo Harrison has the ball in his hands. Well, Falua Stent, you kind of have to foul now. You're down by 4, and there's 8 seconds difference between the game clock and the shot clock. So Chris Doe time usually makes the big shots. Chris Doe down the middle, puts the floater, doesn't get it. Well, now they got to get a quick basket. Djordjevic down the middle. Djordjevic missed the layup. Well, ladies and gentlemen, at the end of this one, Promete are going to go 2-0 here in the round of 16 as they win this one 91-87 over Falua Stent here. Well, this is the round of 16 in the Basketball Champions League. It was a great game of basketball. Mirabalan, the miracle, inspired Promete to a victory tonight. Well, what a game he had. 38 points, 10 rebounds with a double-double, finishing with 1 assist in that matter and 2 blocks. The visiting fans there from Ukraine, Ronan Ginzburg, his team had a rocky start to the Basketball Champions League this year. They were dubbed as the team that were going to make the biggest noise, silently expected to do well, and they are meeting those expectations. The Croatian sensation, Mirabalan, led the way. 29 for 50 for within the rainbow. Only 7 three-point field goals and 1 more rebound for that batter. 21 assists for Falua Stent, the 13, but 4 steals for Prometea. And the Ukrainian team just got the job done. D'Angelo Harrison with 22, 19 for DJ Kennedy, but it was all about the Croatian sensation. Where has Mirabalan been this season? He averages 7 points per game, but again, he is looking like his old self, as he did for Dinamo Sassari, and it was that kind of game. There he is, goes to applaud the fans. The miracle, Mirabalan. What a performance it was from him tonight. Well, it was just a fantastic game of basketball. Could have gone either way this evening. Amita Brima, of course, had a very good game defensively, had 5 block shots in this game, but again, it wasn't enough to get his team over the final hurdle. That was the alley-oop play that he almost connected with, which he felt there was a foul call, but nothing was called in the end. Levi Randolph had a very good second half in this game. Took a bit of time to get his game going. But again, hit some big shots for his team to try and get them back in this one. And D'Angelo Harrison, again, another top performance from him. Well, in the end, of course, Levi Randolph finished with 9 points. He was 4-for-11 from the field this evening. And then again, the big story tonight was Miro Bolan running in transition there for Promete.